In this video, you'll see how you can manage your application portfolios with AWS Systems Manager Application Manager. With this feature, you can automatically discover applications, take action on application resources using runbooks, and quickly diagnose and resolve operational issues. Let's go to Systems Manager to access Application Manager. The overview page contains Getting Started links for learning more about viewing imported applications, monitoring applications, and investigating and remediating issues. The page also gives a snapshot of the issues, applications, and container clusters centralized in this AWS Systems Manager account. Let's view the Application tab. Application Manager automatically imports metadata about your resources that were created in other AWS services or Systems Manager capabilities and displays those resources in predefined categories. Let's look at our CloudFormation stacks. Application Manager has automatically discovered 10 stacks in our account. An important feature throughout Application Manager is that we can make changes to AWS services directly without having to leave the console. For instance, we can create a new stack right here, rather than having to separately access the AWS CloudFormation console. We can launch an existing template or even create a new one from here. We can conversely access Application Manager from the AWS CloudFormation console. Let's select the first stack. From the Stack Actions menu, we can choose to view the stack in Application Manager. Seamless coordination across services simplifies the management and organization of our applications. Let's return to the Application Manager console. We can manage the templates for our CloudFormation stacks in the template library. We can use Amazon provisioned templates or create our own. We can also share our templates with others, and they can share templates with us. Next, let's look at our custom application. We can design applications with unique components based on tags, a resource group, or a CloudFormation stack. Let's build a sample application. To save time, we can choose components using key value tags. For example, we can build the application to include every resource in our dev environment. We can also specify a resource group to include all resources in that group or choose one or more CloudFormation stack components. We have the option to add tags to help identify and filter our custom applications. These tags are not applied to the components or resources specified earlier. We can also manage application stacks and resources created with the AWS Launch Wizard service. As with the other managed applications, we can create a deployment directly from Application Manager. For this example, let's configure an Active Directory application. The Launch Wizard walks us through all the parameters we can define. Lastly, the service coordinates with App Registry in AWS Service Catalog. App Registry is a repository of the applications in our Service Catalog portfolios. Let's visit AWS Service Catalog to see what our applications look like from that end. Here we can see the application ID, Amazon Resource Name, or ARN, and its resources and attribute groups. Here we can see the attribute group metadata. With the click of a button, we can view the application directly in Application Manager. Conversely, from Application Manager, we can click to view the application in App Registry. Next, now that we've seen the close integration between Application Manager and our AWS resources, let's learn about Application Manager's features. We'll drill into this application's child component, which is where our resources are. The Overview tab displays widgets we've enabled to show our operational work items, or ops items, running costs, CloudWatch monitoring alarms, runbooks logs, and other insights. The Resources tab lets us see all the resources in our stack. In this case, we have more than 30 resources, including CloudWatch alarms, a secret manager secret, IAM roles, log groups, an RDS database cluster, and Amazon Simple Storage, or Amazon S3, buckets. From here, we can manage individual resources. For instance, we can see a resource's timeline in AWS Config to see all the events that have been recorded. We can also execute runbooks for individual resources. The listed runbooks are specific to the resource type selected. We can also drill into a specific resource. For this database instance, we can review its tags, resource description, CloudWatch alarms, AWS config details, and CloudTrail logs. Let's return to the Application Manager view of the App Registry application. From the Application's Resources tab, we can manage most resources directly using their URL link. For instance, we can go to this AWS Elastic File System resource. The Resources tab also contains an AWS Cost Explorer tool for the application. We can modify the time period and volume of data represented on the graph. Let's show the daily cost over the last 3 months. We can select a line or bar graph representation. To utilize Cost Explorer's full capabilities, we can open it in the AWS Cost Management console. Here we have many more filter options and we run reports. Next, let's review the application's compliance information in Application Manager. For each resource, we can see any non-compliant rules and whether configuration changes were made. Let's view compliance for an S3 bucket resource. The S3 bucket has one non-compliant rule. At the bottom of the page, we can see all the bucket rules and confirm which is non-compliant. We can also add config rules and take remediation actions from here. Let's see what remediation actions are available for this non-compliant rule. We can manage the remediation or reevaluate the rule. We'll resolve this non-compliant rule later, so for now we can move on. We can also review and assign state manager associations for this application. Let's move on to the monitoring tab. Because we have AWS CloudWatch Application Insights enabled, it will identify any problems encountered with the application. We can see one problem of medium severity. This problem has already reached a resolved status, but let's drill down to learn more. The summary link opens the problem summary in the CloudWatch Management Console. It looks like the alarm was set off early in the application launch by one of the metrics being collected about our Amazon RDS database cluster. No action was needed on our part since the problem resolved itself quickly. The Monitoring tab also aggregates data on the application's alarms. We can see alarms by AWS service. Recently triggered alarms are represented on a dashboard. We also have the option to view a cross-service dashboard in AWS CloudWatch. This dashboard provides more detailed information on recent alarms and problems detected by Application Insights. Next, we'll view the Ops Items tab. From this page, we can view existing Ops Items using the filter or create new Ops Items. We can also change the status of individual Ops Items without having to leave Application Manager. Let's move on to the Logs tab. This list includes all Amazon CloudWatch logs log groups for the current account. We can use the URLs to access the log groups directly. Finally, let's review the Runbooks tab. Here we can see any existing runbook logs for the application or start a runbook. We can access all the available runbooks from here, whether they are Amazon-owned or ones we created. The non-compliant resource we reviewed earlier was missing encryption. Let's search for a relevant runbook. We'll choose the first option, which applies to S3 buckets. Using the Automation Runbook Wizard, we can quickly configure our runbook to target any S3 buckets in the CloudFormation stack of our application. We'll select the child component as the resource group. Now we'll execute the runbook document. The runbook executed successfully. Let's return to Application Manager to review a few more of its capabilities. let's take a quick look at our Launch Wizard application. This application has some Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud or Amazon EC2 instances running. We can click into an instance to edit the resource. From here, we can edit tags and start runbooks without having to open the EC2 console. We can get details from AWS config and included CloudTrail logs as well. Let's go back to the Launch Wizard application. Application Manager is also capable of launching the Patch Manager feature directly. This makes it easy to install patches on applications as needed. Let's return to Application Manager and look at one more feature, container clusters. Application Manager integrates with Amazon Elastic Container Service, or Amazon ECS, and Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, or Amazon EKS, to provide information about the health of your cluster infrastructures. For instance, we can see the EKS and Kubernetes versions this cluster is using. We can also dive into individual components to see their compute and resource usage. You've just seen how you can manage your application portfolios with Application Manager in AWS Systems Manager. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.